Most people are grounding to get rid of hum. I use it for tone. Here goes my OCD again. I can't have that wire touching that. And no, that's not something that makes a difference in the sound. In that video I did with Paulo, just moving it over an inch and a half. And if you want to know the complete truth, that ground I moved over wasn't even the channel he was playing on. It was a gain for the other channel, but it affected that channel. So maybe if I sound arrogant, I don't mean to. I've just figured some of that stuff out, which it blows me away that you can do some of that stuff. And really, sometimes it just boils down to, it's like, who was it? Jason Lawler, I think, with his pickups in an advertisement, or maybe it was on in an interview, and he said, if most of this stuff, it's all just experimenting, and a lot of it's mistakes and finding out why something did something that it did. It's not really that you, for tone like this, I mean, the guitar amp should be an instrument. The size of this wire. Is that a secret? I don't know. Does it matter if it's a secret? Maybe you think my amps suck, so it doesn't really matter. Wouldn't matter all then, would it? And you probably think I'm a total flake. It doesn't matter to me. I remember working with Brian Doherty. I'm really sad that he's passed on. He was one of the founders of Big Wreck. And I remember he came to me, and we had built him a really beautiful grinder. He had an endorsement with Duesenberg. And Duesenberg had that lap steel that had, you could, had a tele bridge on it that you could bend, so it became more like a pedal steel in a way. And what he wanted out of that grinder was a sound like David Lindley with the Dumble, only bigger. He wanted it. He threw his arms apart really wide or something. And so we did that, but the clean channel was basically just like a super reverb, like a Fender, like a Blackface style. And he did a tour, and then when he came back from the tour, he said, I gotta change that clean channel. It's clean. I said, yeah. He goes, well, I said, and I told him what it basically was, and he said, I said, what don't you like about it? He said, well, not that. And basically I had one 12AX7 to work with, because I found that even, and you techs can try this if you want, you'll see, just put a dropping resistor, power supply dropping resistor, and another capacitor on even just a stock Marshall at the end, as if you were going to add another channel. You change the sound. Don't even add the circuitry. Just doing that adds a little more filtering to that. Reacts totally different, just like the type of electrolytics will make it sound different. So I couldn't change even that dropping resistor to the 12AX7 or the filter cap after the design was done, because he did not want anything at all to change. And it's because of guys like that pushing me to that limit. We started at 9 in the morning. I ended up putting it back together at 10 at night. Just working on one 12AX7, because he literally wanted to be able to strum a chord with his fingernail. He's a Berkeley graduate that was a great player, but he also had a great ear. And he would just strum across with his fingernail, and it would be nice and loud and clean, but he wanted it to go into harmonic overtones, even though it was just sitting clean. Eventually he got the mojo because it does that perfectly. It's really rich. In fact, with him, here's another quick story. He was playing the mojo here one time, and I was hoping to find a different output transformer because the one I have is just so expensive. And we were playing here with it. I was subbing in while he was getting ready for another tour, and we were throwing this thing together. So subbing in two or three other output transformers I had. And as we started to do that, the tone obviously was changing, but he was just playing on the verge of breakup and clean. And he sat there and he looked at me and he said, "Do you hear that?" "Well, yeah, of course." "Hear what?" And he said, "That the fifth." And I goes, "Yeah, yeah, I hear the fifth." "What's the fifth?" So he played the fifth. He said, "I've got to fret it." He said, "Now watch, I'll play the chord again." And the fifth was in there. And the output transformer, the original, was producing that. We subbed in another. It was gone. I said, "I can't believe that an output transformer with the inductance and everything the way that it's responding can actually add." Now, obviously, the fifth wasn't the fundamental. It was an overtone. It was incredible. So I've never been able to change that transformer. And that transformer, unfortunately, really cost me a lot. Kind of drives me nuts, but it is very unique. So it's having guys like here where I never would have noticed, because I never would have played that one chord, for instance, and never would have heard that. I'm rambling too much, so let's go into fast mode and get some more work done.